Good morning, traders. Welcome to this video on the euro dollar and pound dollar. My name is Chris from Money Currency. We're going to take a look at the markets, of course, right now. By the way, SWAT course 2.0 is ready or will soon be ready end of this week. So for those that are already SWAT members, you're going to get an update very soon. There are going to be 70 plus, I think 72 videos in total, 72 or 74, 22 plus hours of materials. It's split in two sections, education and SWAT related materials, new SWAT systems, new SWAT indicators. So a lot of good stuff. And of course, within a few weeks from now, there will be also a SWAT book or ebook, I should say, or a big guide, in fact, that you can get as a member as well. So check that out if you're interested. All right, let's take a look at the euro dollar now. So basically kind of a reversal chart pattern taking place here, this rising wedge. We talked about it on Monday already. There was a continuation signal here. As you can see, we had basically a break with the fractals moving away from 20A, pullback and continuation right here going for about 50 pips higher, with price hitting resistance of the trend line and now moving lower again. So these rising wedges are nasty, difficult to trade. If there's a break below this trend line, maybe break below, I would say probably kind of the important candle right here, this candle with the low at 109.20. If it breaks through that, I think there's a fair chance of some retracement to the downside. There could be a bearish break for downside. The moving averages are on top of each other going sideways, so that's a little bit difficult. So therefore, I think the breakout will not necessarily move too far, 108.50, and the price could snap back to those moving averages at that level. If price is able to break through that kind of support zone at 108.25, 108.50, then we might be looking at a bigger breakout down to the 88.6 fever here at 106.90. And that we can see a challenge of the previous bottom. And that would be, of course, a key decision zone for next bounce or break spot. If, on the other hand, it does bounce at 108.50 or even here at the 21 EMA, there could be another push up to 110.40.50 area. That could be resistance because of this trend line, by the way. And there could be a bounce back to those moving averages. If it breaks above 110.50, then finally we have a bigger space up to WIS 8 and the 78.6 FIB here at around 112.50, 112.75, 113.25 in this zone right here. So let me use my drawing tool like that, basically. That zone would be possible if we break above that trend line. And same for this trend line, we could see a bigger move. So for the moment, more range, corrective territory, and price could struggle to break out of this zone. And if price moves up or moves down, there's a good chance of price snapping back to kind of the mean or average zone, which is around 109, 110, basically, for the moment. So, volatility slowing down a little bit on the euro dollar here. Pound USD continues higher. If I remember correctly, this is something we did expect because on Monday, because it looked like an ABC and it looked like price wasn't going to be able to push away from the 20A for one more move up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now it's wave 5 finished. Maybe not quite yet. Let's take a look at the hourly chart. There we go. And it could be that this is wave 1, 2. All of that is a wave 3. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's still one wave 4 left. So let's put the FIB from here to here on this wave 3, if that is the wave 3. Looks like that at the moment. There we go. So could be still bullish as long as price stays above the 23, 38.2 and the 50 fib. That could still be reasons for bounce at 125, 125, 25, for instance. If it breaks through the 144 EMA, which is here, and if it breaks through the 50 fib, then we're looking at a bearish territory and looking for a flag and continuation lower at that point. Because in that case, back to the 4-hour chart, if it does break through the 50 fib, it's breaking through the 21 EMA of the 4-hour chart as well. It's breaking through the previous tops that were broken now and the 125 round level. So yeah, if it breaks through that zone, price could be retracing all of this swing, basically. So that could be some decent space to the downside. In that case, I would put a fib on the entire move up, right, like this. Okay. And I would personally would be looking for a retracement to the 38 or 50 or 61.8 fib zones. Those could be, of course, the targets for the downside, even the 78. Difficult to say which one at this moment. We'll have to see how it falls. But you can see a lot of space, even to the 38.2 fib is 121.75. So, you know, a lot of bearish space. So for the moment, this is bullish territory, and I wouldn't be surprised personally if it goes to this support zone and bounces. We're in a bullish momentum. You can see the bulls are in control. Price is above 21. 21 is above 144. Fractals are above the 21. Price is above 21. So we have an uptrend. So I wouldn't be surprised if it's possible for price to hit this and then bounce one more time and move up to maybe 127, 127.50. But if it breaks to that 50 fib, of course, then it looks bearish. All right, that's my 2 cents at least on the euro dollar and pound dollar. Wish you all great trading and see you in the next video next week. Cheers. Bye-bye.